So this is our first time to do English and Cantonese at the same time. So some little difficulties might come up, but we're gonna start. So what do you think about what is a mental health? Any ideas, opinions?
有什么意见吗? 有什么想法吗? 什么是身心的健康?
No. So, do you think it's treatment for the crazy people or a treatment for weak people?
你们会觉得是一个给疯了的人, 还是一些很弱的人的一些情况吗?
What's the difference between psychiatry and psychology?
对于 psychiatry 和 psychology, 你们会知道有什么的分别吗?
So, I want to know if you have any ideas about mental health.
所以就想看看各位有没有对于身心健康的一些想法或者是一些经验可以跟我们去讨论。
So you can unmute and say something if you want to. Anyone?
或者是你们可以 unmute 自己，还有就是用 chat 的 function 也可以。
Okay, sounds like no one. Okay. All right, so mental health is not only mind. It's integration of the mind and other things. So emotional, psychological, and social well-being.
所以精神健康不只是一个我们的就是精神上面的问题，其实跟我们的身体也是很有关系的，它是影响我们情绪。 还有心理，还有很多地不同地方的一些情况。So,
these things affected your thinking, feeling, also your action.
所以呢，它会影响我们怎么去想，怎么去感觉我们的感觉，还有我们的行为。So
also, mental health including how to handle your stress or making choice. Also socialization.
所以它也是会影响我们怎么去处理压力啊，怎么跟其他人相处啊，或者是去选择的时候，我们怎么去做选择也是会影响的。So
basically mental health is, you know, lifelong thing. Even infant has some mental health condition. Then also adult, older adult has a mental health condition also.
所以呢，其实精神健康、身心健康呢，不只是一个阶段性的情况，它是从我们从幼儿的时候，到儿童的阶段，还有就是青少年，还有成年的阶段，也是会影响我们的。Brian,
do you want to add something in this idea? No.
Oh, sorry, I didn't know I'm muted all the time. Yeah, go ahead, sorry.
Okay. All right, I'm gonna go to the next one. So, start with cognitive functioning. What is a cognitive functioning?
So,
basically, cognitive functioning is about your brain functioning. So it's including, you know, how to think, that's concentration, also attention, memories, decision making. So analyzing something and processing something, some reasoning and communication skills.
所以认知能力呢，其实分很多种的，包括就是我们专注的能力，比如说我们的记忆的能力，比如说我们去做决定啊，去 等等我们的速度等等的能力，还有沟通的能力。
So cognitive function is important. If it's not working well, so it will be affected your everyday life. Also, you know, you can not function well in daily life.
所以如果就是我们的认知的能力受影响的时候，我们生活上面很多不同的地方也会是有受影响的。比如说，就是我们去做决定啊，有时候我们会忘记很多东西啊，还有就是很难去专注等等。
Brian, do you have any comments about this one?
Basically, like you said, mental health it does have a really good correlations between our cognitive thinking, just like how we think, how we process, analyze situations, how it affects our communication skills and memories, and it does play a huge role on our everyday life.
Yes, so that's the cognitive functioning. Also emotion. So we go to brain, now it goes to heart. So emotion also affected mental health condition. So if you have good mental health condition and good emotional situation, so basically positive emotions, namely joy, happiness, joyness, joyfulness, hopefulness, optimism, good self-esteem, these things. So how can I say, as emotions, not only emotion affected emotion, it's also affected other side of the mental health.
所以另外一个关于身心健康的就是我们的情绪，如果我们有好的情绪的时候，就会有很多正面的影响，比如说我们会开心啊，我们会感觉有希望，然后我们的自信心，对自己的信心也是会有一个正面的影响。
So always emotions related to other mental health functioning. Also, if it's your poor emotions, that's really frustrated, sadness, always negative feeling in your side, in your inside.
那如果我们是有负面的情绪的时候，我们就会感觉很不开心，然后很紧张，比如说有很多愤怒在我们的心里。So
Brian, do you want to add about emotions?
No, you did a good job.
Okay. So, okay, next one is action behaviors. So now, brain, then heart, then now our actions, behaviors. So behaviors sometimes affected your emotion and also cognition too. So good mental health condition also considered a good behavior. So for example, so now it's coronavirus situation pandemic. So if you go out, even it's the difficult situation, you may have good emotion, feel happier or feel refreshed. So it's actions also related to your emotion. Also, you know, if you go to outside and walk around, your brain functioning works get better too. So it's related to other functioning. So good mental health condition with action and behavior. So,
所以呢，就是下一个就是我们行为方面也是会有受我们的身心的健康影响。譬如说，我们有好的身心的健康的时候。 比如说现在是COVID的时间，我们出去走走啊，或者是我们做一些正面的行动，比如说出去的时候去走走，跟其他人去微笑一下，跟其他人去沟通一下，其实也是会对我们的身心的健康有一个正面的影响。
So, including involving social services, social community activities. So, also your action, handling your difficulties in your life or stress.
所以其他的地方，譬如说我们去参加一些社会的活动，还有就是去学习怎么去减压。
So on the other side has poor mental health condition with action and behavior. So some people isolated. So it's a lot of people now isolated. So it's definitely affected their mental health. Also sometimes, irritable mood, then it's yelling, verbal aggression, some people have physical aggression. These things also impacted relationship with others. Also, the behavior affected your body. Some people have stomach ache, headache, some somatic symptoms. Also, poor adaptation, which means adapted to new environment that's affected to you.
所以如果是我们有不太好的身心的健康的情况时候，也是会有很多状况去出现的。譬如说，就是我们会觉得很孤单，有时候我们对其他人的态度也会有一些改变。譬如说，我们会变得比较行为上面或者是行动上面也是比较暴力一点啊，或者态度没有这么好啊。所以呢。 久而久之就会影响我们跟其他人的关系。比如说，我们会也是身体上面也会出现很多不同的情况，譬如说头痛啊，肚子痛啊，很多的情况。Okay,
Brian, do you want to add something for these reactions?
So, from the previous slides, we talked about how thinking affecting emotions, and those two components definitely will affect our behavior, such as like if we don't feel good about ourselves and we start ruminations, and how those two components lead to maladaptive behaviors.
所以就是之前那个slide也是有提到，如果我们心情或是情绪不好的时候，其实也是会影响我们的行为的。所以所有的关系，我们的认知、情绪还有就是行为方面，全都是有关联的。
So Brian, maybe you can explain the next slide.
You mean like this one?
Yeah.
So basically how to maintain a good mental health, and the mental health is just a really part of a psychological well-being. And this well-being is definitely including our mental status, physical and social. And in order to maintain a good mental health, we need to take care of our bodies and minds, which is including our psychological well-beings, feelings, and interpersonal relationships. And it's all combined together as a whole.
所以呢，当我们是说身心健康的时候，只是有三个部分的。第一个就是身体上面的健康，另外一个呢就是心理上面的健康，然后第三个呢就是社交上面的健康。然后每一个部分，他们都是需要有好的。
情况我们才会有一个很好的情绪。So, as I mentioned, it's not only one aspect affected. One aspect, it's not functioning well. It's affected other pieces.
所以呢，其实只要有一个地方我们去。 是有一些负面，或者是感觉不太好，无论是就是身体上面，或者是心理上面，或者是社交上面，我们有什么问题的时候，其实也是会影响另外的两个方向的。Okay,
now we're gonna talk about psychological well-being. So, how it's mental health related to psychological well-being. So Brian, do you want to continue talking about this one?
So like mental health is just like we just talked about a little bit before. Mental health is associated with the psychological well-being. So what is the psychological well-being? It's a person realize it's like a own abilities to cope with normal stresses of life and maintain positive attitude, have a sense of purpose in life. And these well-being is help us to connect every single component that's involved in our lives on a daily basis, such as our families, like we talked about earlier too, cognitive functionings and emotions, and this psychological well-being is definitely would adapt in ourselves as a whole.
所以呢，身心健康呢，其实是一个我们。 了解自己的一个能力的一个过程，比如说我们去了解自己可不可以怎样去面对压力啊，怎样去维持一个正面的态度啊，还有就是去寻找就是对于生命的意义等等的方向。然后当我们有一个好的身心的健康的时候，其实就是我们会对我们身体生活上面不同的范畴，比如说是家庭的关系。
So make sure we be in a positive this side. It's three components together. It's not only one portion. It's every aspect. So it's related.
所以就留意就是。 我们常常都是说三个主要的情况，就是身体、心理还有社交方面，全都是会有影响的。Okay,
so psychological well-being also we can break down. Let's start with physical health. So. Basically, we have physiological needs. So it's including sleep, eat, also sheltering. These things affected our physical health.
所以第一个范畴呢，就是我们身体上面的健康。譬如说，我们其实是有一些需要的身体的需要，基本的需要。譬如说，我们是要睡觉啊。 吃东西啊，等等，都是我们基本的一些身体上面的需求。So
in order to maintain psychological well-being, we need eat. Also, eat and maintain good nutrition. It's not make sure it's balanced nutrition. Also, we need exercise regularly. Also, drinking water. That's important for us. Also sleep, that's affected to your physical well-being. Also, you know, we need physical checkup regularly.
所以就是我们如果是要照顾自己的身体健康的话，那当然就是我们吃东西的时间要按时吃东西，然后就是我们营养方面啊。 或是我们就运动啊，喝水啊等等，我们睡觉的时间也是会有影响。然后当然最重要也是很重要的，就是要跟我们的医生有一些就是定期的一些去讨论我们的身体的状况。So
when we lost these balances, we tend to get ill. So some signs you can get. Some headache, stomach ache. So sometimes you're breathing too shallow. Dizziness, muscle tightness. It happens to me a lot of time. Lack of sleep, lack of appetite. That happens. So tired always. That happens too. Sometimes affected your blood pressure. Other potential, it's contributed to other potential illness.
所以如果我们身体不健康的时候，我们就会出现很多的不同的状况，比如说头疼啊、肚子疼啊，然后就是我们的呼吸也是会比较浅一些，然后另外就是比如说很头晕啊，甚至是我们的肌肉也是会有很绷紧的情况，然后就是睡眠的时候我们比较难去入睡，然后 吃东西的时候，可能我们比以前就是没有可以吃这么多东西了，然后很容易去疲倦。然后另外一些状况，譬如说是高血压啊，那些等等，都会有很多不同的身体的状态，也是会告诉我们身体上面的健康出现了问题。So
does everybody has any questions for now? You can unmute and ask questions if you want to.
如果是有问题的话，可以 unmute 或者是打出来 在 chat 这边打出来也可以。So
Brian, do you want to add something for the physical health?
Yeah, we can give them more a little more example. For example, like if we don't have enough sleep, and that's definitely would play a huge role in the mental health too. Like when we don't have enough sleep, then probably we might get easily get agitated, frustrated by any type of situation or by people. So it's physical health, it does play a huge role linked to our mental health. And sometimes we don't pay attention to ourselves and how we feel on a daily basis. And because every day we always rushing through the day, working, and then yet we neglect how we feel. And that's why we would like to prompt this to let everybody know that sometimes we have to slow down and pay attention to what we need in our bodies and mind.
所以有时候就是我们可能没有每一天都很留意我们自己的身体的状况，然后就会出现了问题之后才会留意的时候， 那就已经是影响了很多方面的情况了。So,
how we can maintain our physical health? So sleep adequately. So, sounds like at least we need 6 hours. Some people it's not necessary about 6 hours, but recommendation is at least 6 hours. Ideally 8 hours. Also having good hygiene. So in nowadays we have, you know, electronics in our bedroom. So smartphone, tablet, laptop, computer, TVs. So these things affected your sleeping hygiene. So make sure turn off probably an hour before or so. Then you can have good sleep. Also drinking water. So me and Brian has a different opinion. So that's why it's a 51 ounce to 150 ounces. So about 8 cups of the water that we need maintain every day. Otherwise it's gonna be dehydrated. Then usually if I dehydrated, I have headache. So that happens. Then I cannot function well. Exercise regularly. I know it's pandemic, then difficult to go outside, but still we need maintain in our body. So you can go walk outside, also hiking or trails opening. I saw some people do the Tai Chi at the park. Basically get the fresh air, just go outside. We can also do the stretch, yogas. I don't think we cannot do swimming right now, but swimming is good sources too. So healthy eating, routine eating. So eat same time in the morning, lunch and dinner. Balancing meal too. It's not only meat, not only vegetable, but you know, vegetarian eat only vegetable, but you know, just need balance in a vegetable too. Also fruits. So that's important to maintain in order to maintain the physical health.
所以如果是我们要照顾自己的身体健康的时候，有几个方向我们去考虑的。第一个就是我们睡觉的时间要是足够的，就是说我们每一天应该是睡大概6个小时到8个小时左右。然后另外呢，就是睡觉之前，我们尽量就是减少去用我们电子的用品，比如说电话或者是手机或者是电脑等等。 我们在睡觉之前就尽量就是减少他们的使用的情况。另外呢，就是我们喝水的情况也是很重要的。每一天我们建议50亿的ounce到150ounce，或者是大概是8倍水的分量啊，就是对我们身体是最健康的。当然呢，运动也是很重要。比如说我们现在虽然是 COVID 的时候。 但是我们今天也是会出去走走啊，去校外的地方，比如说耍啊踏机啊，或者是我们去做一些瑜伽啊，或者是游泳的情况，也是会对我们身体会有一个正面的影响。最后呢，就是我们吃东西的时候也是会要有一个平衡的营养，比如说我们不可以只是吃肉类的。 食物，比如说我们也是要去吃一些生活啊，或是等等的不同的食物。然后当然就是每一天我们要定时的吃饭，比如说早饭、午餐、晚餐等等都是要定时的。So,
do you have any questions? You can ask English and Japanese or Mandarin.
如果你们有什么问题的时候，你们可以用英语、广东话还有普通话问也可以。No
questions so far? Okay, keep going. So probably Brian can say.
Physical health?
Next one.
So how, like we talk about a little bit earlier, how psychological well-being affect the social functionings. And it does a huge role because everyday interactions with others in environments, and this is a bit like to kind of like share our feelings with others. It's kind of like talking to someone, have someone to talk to, even a long day after a long day, and or anything that you feel frustrated or angry, and you have someone to talk to or someone to share your problem is definitely can help maintain mental health, because if we don't find someone to talk to, and we so easily to isolate ourselves, and the more isolate ourselves, it definitely could affect our not just physical body as also mental health as well. And it's another way of to take care of ourselves. And sometimes we just want to talk to, you know, someone to share our feelings. And that's a part of a social aspect to maintain the psychological well-being.
所以另外一个就是我们社交上面的需要，就是每一个人其实我们也是会有时候是会想要跟其他人去分享我们的生活，比如说是我们的伴侣啊，或者是我们的朋友啊，或者是其他的家人，就是当我们是有情感的需要的时候，我们很容易就是会想去找一个人去跟我们聊一聊情况。 然后，如果我们就是当时候没有找到其他人的时候，可能我们就会觉得很孤单，然后会觉得没有人跟我们去分享等等。所以这样，如果我们没有一些社交上面的照顾自己的情况，那我们身体上面，然后心理上面也会慢慢出现很多的毛病。So
now it's pandemic. It's difficult to maintain the social aspect. I know it's tough, but we can be creative how to connect the other people. So, you know, even we have difficulties, still we have way to connect to others. So some people using Zoom maintain the group, then just talk something. also do something together. That's I see to maintain the social aspect of the psychological well-being.
所以现在虽然是就是 COVID pandemic 的情况，我们不可以就是真实的见到我们的朋友或者是家人，但是我们可以用一些比较有创意的方法去跟其他人去联系的，比如说透过 Zoom 的时候，我们可以跟其他人有一些meeting 啊聚会啊，然后就是或者是我们可以开一个 Zoom 的 group 出来，就是一起做一些东西也是可以的。
Okay. So, how we can maintain social aspect? So, Brian, can you continue that one?
So, we would spend some quality time together. It's like, you know, with friends and families, maintain try to maintain contact, text message, emails, phone calls. Just for example, just even for me, if I don't talk to anybody on a daily basis, just throughout the days, throughout the weeks, and it's very easy for me to get frustrated, and it seems like nobody understands, and it's so easy for me to isolate. So it's very important to find someone to talk to, anybody, and so that's how we maintain social aspect, and also have open communications to talk to others with our feelings, and also encourage your friends and families also talk to you too. So that way we have that way we can maintain a very good quality of relationship together.
所以有几个方向是这样上面，当然如果我们可以真的跟其他人去花时间跟其他人在一起，当然是很好。如果不可能的时候，我们也可以用其他的方法，比如说 FaceTime 啊，或者是传短信啊，email 啊，或者是打电话给他们啊，等等。当然，就是我们不同的家人啊、朋友啊，或者是甚至是我们工作上面的一些伙伴，也是对我们很重要的。当你们去跟他们去沟通的时候，最好就是也是会告诉他们你们的感觉，然后你们每一天的情绪是怎样等等。
So we at least I have my family in different side of the Pacific. So most of the people in the Asian population, especially first, second generation, has family members in other country. So, but now technologies developed, then we can do FaceTime, Zoom, any format of the electronic communication we can do. So I try to maintain my communication with parents at least once a week, that I do. So still we can do some connection with our family members.
当然，我们有很多是移民来到美国的人，可能会有家人是在不同的国家的，然后我们也是要跟他们定期有一些沟通，比如说Hero 他就是每一个星期也是会打电话，或者是跟他的父母去沟通的，所以就是就算是你们的家人是在不同的国家，也是去找一个。
All right. Do you have any question about social aspect or any opinions?
有什么问题吗? 对于我们的社交方面的?
Nope. Okay. Keep going. So now we're gonna talk self-care. What is self-care? So what we can do? So actually in the mental health field, that's we learn first things, self-care. So we make sure maintain ourselves, then we can treat others. So self-care means take care of ourselves. So we mentioned about different aspects of the psychological well-being. So maintain these things. So make sure it's balancing between our mind, emotion, physical health, also our environment, that maintain these things together. So that's a social, self-care. So sometimes we need take off from our little chaotic situation, work situation. So make sure keep the boundary. So in my experience, it's once getting to tend to keep going, but doesn't function that way. Sometimes we need to stop and then make sure maintain myself before go far that way. Also do something to enjoy things. We can do anything. So some people do meditation, breathing exercise, walking or reading. So especially I love fishing, then I go to fishing sometimes, but sometimes I cannot go, just think about fishing. So I can release my mind from my work or other difficulties. So try to do something at least once a week, ideally, but you can do more then takes at least 30 minutes to an hour at least. So I mentioned if we cannot take care of ourselves, we cannot take care of others. So as a mental health professional, we always aware of the self-care. So that's an important thing.
所以下一个就是我们教顾自己的情况，就是如果我们去学习怎么去教顾自己的话，我们是会有很多对我们心理上面或者是身体上面健康有是正面的影响。比如说，第一个我们可以做的就是去给自己一些情况，就是休息一下，比如说。去工作啊，或者是想学啊，或者是教父小朋友啊等等的时间，也是需要有一些休息的情况的，就是给自己停下来，就是给自己一些时间去休息。然后另外一个呢，就是去做一些你真的享受的活动，比如说冥想啊，呼吸的练习啊，或者是。就是出去走走啊，或者是如果是喜欢阅读的朋友，你可以去读书啊等等，就是做一些你们真的去享受的，自己可以做的一些活动。第三个呢，就是如果以上的活动你们每一个星期可以有30分钟到1个钟头，1个小时的时间去给自己，已经是很好了。因为当我们如果没有可以照顾自己的时候，那我们就很难也去照顾其他人的。我们是先需要去照顾自己，然后才可以去照顾我们身边的其他人。所以如果是真的觉得有很大的压力的时候，我们也是可以去找一些专业的人士去讨论自己的情况。因为有时候我们跟专业的人士去讨论的时候，他们反而可以给我们一些建议，去看看我们可以怎么去解决我们心理上面或者是身体上面的一些压力的情况。
So Brian, do you have anything to add for the self-care?
Self-care, I always encourage people to take to do self-care at least 30 minutes each day, and that helps a lot because 30 minutes can take us away from all these pressures or work, and it's kind of like give yourself, I call it me time. Me time is the only personal time that I can do the things I would like to do, things that I like for example, watching TV, anything that helps us to refresh ourselves and recharge our batteries or energies to face any problems that we may have. in the futures. So it's just really good to practice 30 minutes of self-care every day.
所以 Brian 就是建议，如果我最好的时候，就是我们每一天都有 30分钟去照顾自己的活动，就是最好了。譬如说，因为他会觉得啊，我们 30分钟的时候，其实就是可以好像一个充电的一个活动，让每一天我们如果可以做 30分钟，那我们那一天就会精神上面也会觉得很精神。
Do you have any question about self-care? Or you can share your experience about self-care.
That's great.
I think there's another important aspect in this self-care component because we always want to provide care to others, but then yet we neglect how to take care of ourselves. And that's an old saying we all know. It's like, if we don't know how to take care of ourselves, then how can we take care of others? And that's why we're encouraging people to like try to, you know, take self-care 30 minutes every day and see how it goes. And you may find yourself, you feel refreshings, or you may find yourself more enjoyable to handle all these pressures that you're in life.
另外一个情况就是我们通常很习惯就是照顾我们身边的其他人，反而就是忽略了自己的需要，就是所以反而没有好好的照顾自己。所以如果每一天我们就是停下来，花30分钟的时间，就是给自己的时候，我们也是会有一个充足的能量去继续的可以照顾我们身边的其他人。
Actually, this concept is difficult for the Asian people because we are collective culture. So always we need to think about others than ourselves. So it makes it a little difficult. Actually, myself, it was really difficult to do self-care, taking self-care in the beginning of my early career. But, you know, every year I learn how to do my self-care. It's sometimes still difficult, but it's way better now. So even out, you know, in a collective culture, we need to see ourselves and maintain and do the self-care.
所以就是去亚洲人就是比较难去会想到要照顾自己，因为我们就是一个。 去跟其他人很有关联的一个文化，所以常常我们是会想怎么去照顾其他人，反而就是会忘记了我们也是要照顾自己。所以就算是我们是专业的人士，也是一个学习的一个过程，不是每一天都会记得要去照顾自己的。所以就慢慢去学习，慢慢就是给自己多一点时间。
Okay, now switch the gear. So we talk about how to maintain ourselves, talking about mental health well-being. But even we do mental health well-being, sometimes it's difficult. So some people has a stigma ourselves. So people has these kind of the thought. So I must be successful and cannot show sign weakness. People think their concerns are too private or family issues. So just, it's my issue. Also it's a burden to share my emotion. Also, sometimes we think it's a disrespect. So afraid to telling somebody it's not respect with others. Sometimes we think about that way. Also, I don't know how to talk about mental health with my family, especially, you know, we are not familiar with the taboo issues with family. mental health services for people who are crazy, or different world. That's, we can label different world. So that's a kind of the mental health stigma most people has, who hesitate to come to talk to other people. So Brian, do you have any other addition for this one?
We can have a huge cultural component in this piece, because we Asian families, Asian culture, we don't tend to talk to our problems with families or friends, and it's even more difficult to seek help when it comes to mental health, and especially mental health. These two words already create a stigma, because mental means like it's crazy behind it, and it's like telling people stories and letting people think that am I crazy. So that is the huge component part that is preventing us to seek help when it's needed.
Sorry, Isabel, I should ask you.
所以就是我们就是在心理的健康上面，尤其是亚洲人，就是会有很多对于精神健康有一些负面的感觉，或者是有觉得是有一些受洗的感觉。譬如说，就是会觉得我们如果是精神健康有问题的时候，就是代表我们这个人是很弱，或者是就是。 这一些方面的东西我们很少跟其他人去分享，会觉得是一些个人或者是我们家里自己的问题，所以很少去跟外面的人去分享的。然后很多人也会觉得，如果是常常要分享自己的感受的时候，是很难的去分享自己的感受，然后就会觉得，如果是 常常跟其他人去分享负面的感受的时候，就是有一些不尊重其他人的感觉。然后有时候甚至是对于我们自己的家庭、家人的时候，也是会觉得很难不知道怎么去说。然后最常常呢，就是亚洲人会觉得我们心理的健康就是会不会跟疯了是一样的，就是我们会用很多负面的词语去 形容我们心理的状态，因为我们觉得如果是心理上面出现的问题，就是我们整个人都是好像疯了，很有问题的情况。所以特别是亚洲人，我们对于精神健康上面是有很多误解，还有很多负面的一些想法。
So do you have any experience this stigma, or someone you know has this kind of stigma?
那我们可以想想，我们自己对于心理的健康，还有或者是我们身边的人，会不会你也有一些经验，就是其他人会对精神的健康是有一些负面的想法？
Feel free to ask, I mean share.
如果是有的话，欢迎你们可以分享出来。
So you may seen the situation before, so if you can, you know, share the experience would be great.
就是如果你们以前有一些经验，就是看过自己或者是其他人对于心理上面的健康是有一些负面的想法的话，可以跟我们去分享一下。I
think I see the times like 10:51 already, and we may not have enough time to do Cantonese in the same way. Do you think so? So I'm gonna speak in this part in Cantonese too, if I may. Because 咁多年來，我哋都保持一個心態，就話同人傾偈，即係代表我哋自己唔識得控制自己啦。同或者家或又或者係家丑不出外傳，又或者我哋諗住心理醫生睇心理醫生，我哋都心都冇心理唔平衡，點解要揾心理醫生嚟睇一即係傾下偈，或者揾專業時傾下偈咧？所以呢一個就係好大個stigma，就係behind就係話我哋就好多 禁忌同埋顧忌，而即係阻住咗我哋去同人開解下， 同埋傾下偈。
All right. So, any other questions? Comments?
Hello, 我係二玲，聽得到嗎？
聽到聽到，你好。誒，你好啊，咁樣我想問問，嗱，我覺得專業人士咧，好多時佢哋就係即係喺嗰個診所啊，或者係醫院入邊，咁係醫患者咧係要同佢哋求助嘅，去到佢哋嗰度問佢哋提出問題嘅，但係好大嘅問題就係我哋啲患者啊，佢哋係唔。 因為呢個病係導致佢哋嘅思維啊、認知啊、行為造成影響，佢哋唔會願意屋企人唔會，即係佢哋唔願意屋企人帶佢出去。咁嗰個時候，作為你哋係專業人士喺診所，咁點樣係即係鼓勵嗰啲人出嚟咧？即係雖然我知道呢個 stigma 係其中一部分啦，咁仲有冇其他嘅，即係有冇其他啲方法可以幫到佢哋咧？
啊，二玲呢個問題問得好好啊！啊，呢其實有好多時候我哋對呢個心理嘅知識咧係好少啦。咁其實再加上我哋唐人之中咧，就啊好誒，即係俾人個錯嘅話，聽就啊我屋企自己有事啊，跟住話自己屋企有病患者啊，就好容易疏忽到就話誒。 就唔好話俾人聽啊！就有咩時候都唔好出嚟求助啊！咁更加做喺家庭裏邊會造成咗好大嘅壓力。所以今次咧，呢個第一次嘅presentation 咧，就係想送俾大家話俾我聽，其實係一個好平常嘅事。跟住我哋有好多專業人士咧，就係好樂意幫大家分享呢一，即係幫大家呢、這個寫咗中文話，即係呢個咁多嘅煩惱，想大家分享下，同埋。
就有好多人就好多專業人士就會好樂意幫助每一個家庭嘅問題咯。希望呢個問題可以答到你。如果答唔到，可以繼續發問嘅係。多謝多謝，我一陣會把我嘅 email 發到去個 chat room 嗰度，到時睇下你得唔得同我聯繫一下，或者係點樣樣，因為我係即係華裔精神健康聯盟嘅代表，所以想進一步咁樣傾傾呢啲問題。 同阿健社嘅 special 呢個 mental health department
啊，得唔得咧？哦，冇問題啊，阿健社就會可以，你可以俾聯絡資料俾阿健社，阿健社一定會好樂意幫助你問題嘅。咁
哦，所以你哋唔係 from 阿健社呢邊？哦，阿健社係請我哋兩個嚟講下講座嘅。
哦，OK，understand，
唔該曬，得，冇問題，冇問題，咁我哋已經同 Amos 有 contact， 同埋 佢哋 brand 都有 contact，OK， 得，唔緊要，我可以或者有專業阿健社專業人士會或者同你提供資料，跟住睇下有咩接，然後有咩幫助啦。
OK，thank you，thank you，thank you，魏生，魏生，我哋魏生，其實今次個活動就係主要係我哋 outreach 嗰個 department 嘅，咁所以就我哋嚟緊都會仲有幾次一啲講座嘅，咁每一個月我哋都定期有一啲講座，所以就即係希望透過一啲講座同分同公眾去分享多啲精神健康上面嘅問題，咁所以如果你想有多啲呢方面嘅資料，咁我哋都可以發嗰啲資料俾你嘅。
OK，thank you，因為我冇收到任何關於呢個workshop
嘅。如果你可以message 我哋，你可以 message 我留低你個電郵啊，咁我可以將。好啊，好啊，好，得，我而家即刻
message 俾你。OK，thank you， 唔該曬。
All right.
Yes.
Do you have other questions or comments? About this topic.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
Hi, my name is Stephanie. I was just wondering, what suggestions do you have on how to start conversations about mental health with my mom? She's of an older generation and doesn't generally talk about her feelings. You know, the focus is never on herself. And now that I'm a mom, I really am more aware of how she's always put others' needs before her own. And I was wondering if you have tips on how I can better speak to her about herself in general.
Yeah, it's really difficult. It's pretty, yeah. So probably my parents' generation, it's a little difficult to talk about it, even they don't have any concept of the mental health. So it's understandable, but so most likely, you know, the generation is denial. So I don't have any problem. I'm okay. So try to hide themselves. I have good experience a couple weeks ago. So I needed to talk to a mom to recommend her son to get into the mental health. The case, my client who diagnosed with mild autism spectrum. So for the mom, it's really difficult to accept the situation. Then she emphasized, you know, her son doesn't have any problem. Okay. He's always happy. That's no problem. He's functioning. That's she said. So I approached a little differently. So what can she see as a difficulties in interaction with him? So I mentioned his possible difficulties. So if he has the kinds of difficulties, probably, you know, in the autism spectrum, people difficult to read other people's emotion. So also misunderstood the emotion. So I asked her if he has the situation, then she said yes. So how about this one? Do you talk about does he express his emotion? Then she said no, not so much. It's never happened at the home situation. So I mentioned it's just difficulties for us. So probably that situation happens. Then mom realized it is difficulties. Then he may need help in these areas. So I approached a little differently than, you know, compared to directly, he needs a, you know, mental health help. Just I listed. So maybe you see the difficulties, then try to get into the, you know, services. So does it make sense?
Yes, kind of try to not mm-hmm. approach it directly, but indirectly mm-hmm. kind of
mm-hmm.
initially go around the problem yeah. to try to get back to where mm-hmm. I'm trying to direct her kind of thing.
Yeah, so you maybe you can, you observe some difficulties with your mom, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I would say I see. And you know, mom, you have these difficulties. What do you think? Then kind of discuss with that loud. So, you know, not directly to introduce mental health, but, you know, just you have concern about her functioning or, you know, decline, these things. So it's made in there, you know, your mom's feeling or, you know, stigma. So that's, I would say. So Brian, do you want to add something? Do you have any opinions?
I think you provide very good feedback for this one.
So do you have any further questions about the situation?
No, that's a good start. Thank you.
Yeah, hopefully it makes sense to you. All right. So do you have any other questions, comments? Okay, sounds like we can move on. So, Brian, you wanna talk about what's the mental health services?
So you want me to speak in English? You want me to speak in Cantonese now?
So you can do Cantonese too, if you want to.
Which is like speaking English and I translate in Cantonese.
Okay, I can. All right, so what is a mental health? So mental health is not fixing the problem. So I don't fix any other people's problem. It's more helping my client to gain knowledge or skills to overcome their challenge or difficulties. So then make sure back to their good quality of life. That's a mental health service goal. So speaking of the skills, it's how to regulate emotions or change habit or attitude, behavior. So, or understanding other people more fully. So make sure using the skills or tools. So also handling your stressors in a life well. It's not just not confronting, just handling these stressors. Also has a better communication with others, make sure connected properly, adequately to other people. So also make sure, balancing everything in our lives. That's what the mental health services is. So who want to go next? Wondering Cantonese?
I can just so 呢簡單啲嚟講啦，咁即係頭先我都講開咗話，其實揾專業人士傾下偈咧，唔係一件唔好事。即係心理醫生啊、社交啊，同埋我哋所有專業人士咧，都想幫大家分擔一下，傾下心事，減輕一下精神壓力啊。輔導下，希望幫到大家解決到生活的問題啦，同埋希望可以協助大家保持身心平衡和活得開心。
Alright,
Mandarin now.
I think I'm going to ask the participants if there are anyone who only speaks Mandarin, but you guys can go ahead first.
Okay.
Alright.So actually almost about to end. So what is a mental health provide?
Yeah, 还是可以问问题吗？请问。
可以可以，你等一下。
就是、
我的国语不好，我的国语不好。不好意思，
okay, 等我讲翻广东话，因为我知道你哋会录俾，所以我想知道有人普通话，有人广东话，你哋都得咁啫嘛。哦，
有，
都可以嘅，系吓，又好快，因为我都唔想阻大家时间，因为我哋有啲朋友咧，有啲嘅经历就话去见医生咧，嗱，讲问到医生话。醫唔醫得好噶咁樣咁，經常醫生嘅答覆咧，有啲醫生就答得好好啦，鼓勵啲。但係有啲專業人士咧，答覆就係話冇得醫好嘅，呢啲病係唔可能，即係唔可能治癒噶。佢即係會點點咁，好似就俾啲病人咧好大嘅，同埋家人好大嘅打擊。咁我想問下，正確咁回答呢個問題嘅嗰啲醫生啊，或者係心理治療師，應該係點樣回答呢個問題嘅？因為我哋知道即係靠治療啊，靠食藥唔一定食藥啊，但係都要長期噶嘛嗬。咁如果話哦冇得醫嘅你呢個病如果係好嚴重，入咗好多次醫院啦，咁佢就 即係佢冇得好，咁但係呢個講法係點樣會講，等啲家人同埋患者都係有希望去做咧，因為咁樣好打擊好大咯。我唔知你我講得清唔清楚，可能要請阿靚女嚟翻譯成英文俾佢哋聽，因為我一陣都有個會，你睇下你。
唔緊要，你解釋得好清楚，我問題係啲乜嘢？多謝。咁緊要，通常咁你都識講啦，通常每一個醫生咧嘅回答咧都係有啲唔同嘅。譬如啦，咁我可以簡單啲嚟講啦，咁睇下係咩病徵啊，個病情有幾嚴重啊，係咪你都識講話識唔識食藥啊？咁食完藥係咪一定要有啲要有呢個心理輔導？ 一齊開始呢個治療啊，其實咧每一個病情都係有唔同個效果嘅。其實譬如話，如果一個簡單啲嚟講啦，譬如一個精神病患者，譬如話聽到啲聲音，即係聽到聲音咧係就話人哋聽唔到啊，見到啲嘢人哋睇唔到咧，呢個情形咧就特別啲，因為呢個通常都係好長期性嘅，要嘅治療同埋要食藥啦。好唔好咧，就要睇個都睇好通好簡單嚟講，係好睇個人而定啦，同埋睇個人而定，不特止同埋睇家庭嘅 support 啦，因為所有嘢都係好多嘢加埋埋嘅，所有因素先可以形成一個最好嘅效果咯。OK，yeah，明白。
我即係希望即係專業人士嗰度咧，盡量唔好俾咁容易一棒。
棍打死嗰種咁嘅，即係等俾我哋好絕望入邊啦，即係好多人反饋，哎呀，我醫生話冇得好，即係佢所定義嗰個好係喺治療嗰方面，可能話而家啲藥啊或者啲家好多都係即係根據症狀嚟調整啲藥物噶嘛，佢唔係根據即係嗰個發病嘅原因，咁你可能就斷唔到個根，但係而家係好有效咁控制咗呢啲，即係可以翻得工啊，翻得學校啊，重新投入社會啊，咁已經係好好啦，所以我覺得即係要俾佢哋一個患者一個或者即係家人一個期望，有個希望你係你個好嘅定義係乜嘢，因為我哋好多朋友都係我唔食藥啦就算好啦，咁好多人就唔啊我唔去睇醫生我就算好啦，所以。 即係斷咗好多啲人嘅嗰種繼續治療嘅嗰種慾望啊，或者係堅持咯，我係咁諗。我有個會，所以好多謝你哋今次組織呢個非常非常好，希望期望更多睇到你哋嘅更多啲會議召開咯。即係嗰啲 workshop 嚟開，好多謝，我哋好好缺啦，好好渴望啊，就係所以就前一秒鐘先知道你哋有一個咁樣嘅 workshop，OK， 好多謝，希望再次知道我，OK，我哋下次再見面啦。好嘅，好嘅 ，thank you，thank you， 唔該曬，好，我而家先去，拜拜。
Any comment or questions？
咁其實呢個環節咧就係話mental health service 係包括同埋啲乜嘢咧？咁可以幫家庭糾爭啊，瞓得唔好啊，食得唔好啊，長期性嘅壓力啊。 同埋小朋友學習有能力，唔係有啦，小朋友學習有問題啊，即係譬如話學習問題嘅意思就話譬如即係讀唔到書意思，即係讀 reading 即係 reading 嘅個 ability 唔係咁好啊，或者接收能力唔係咁好啊，再嚴重啲都會有嘅，就譬如唔係話唔係小朋友嚴重啲，即係話我哋再更加可以有幫助到其他人咧，就係話有。 抑郁病啊，緊張同埋長期性抑郁病啊，焦慮症啊，受到毒品感染啊，暴躁啊，同埋再嚴重啲咧，都會有我哋可以幫助到嗰啲係精神病患者啊，同埋產後抑郁症啊，同埋老人痴呆症等等嘅，其實我哋都包括埋好多種種嘅服務嘅。
所以就是，其实我们那个精神健康方面的服务，其实是很分率是很广泛的。譬如说，就是家庭的问题啊，睡眠的问题啊，或者是压力啊，或者是小朋友的话，就是我们学习能力方面的问题。 那比如说这是自闭啊等等，或者是注意力不足啊的等等的学习 上面的问题。然后另外一些方面呢，就是情绪上面的问题，比如说是忧郁啊，或者是焦虑啊的情况，或者是有一些我们是毒品啊，或者是我们上瘾的一些情况，也是会是要需要就是专业人士的一些辅导。还有就是老人家的一些，比如说老人痴呆啊，这一些问题也是属于我们精神健康上面会处理的一些情况。
So basically we provide these difficulties in our lives. So family issues, that's really common. Sleeping problem, we can help. So eating problem, how stress management, that we can help. Also, learning differences. Some children has some learning differences. So some kids difficult to read, also comprehend these things, we can help too. We have anxiety related difficulties, depression related difficulties. Some people have drug addiction, also substance problem. We have also autism, some behavior problem, also personality differences. So people have some differences, then some people has challenging based on their personality. So we can help these people also. Psychosis is including schizophrenia, that we can help. Also trauma, including PTSD, also Alzheimer's dementia, also bipolar disorder type. So that we can help these things. So, do you have any question about our mental health services? Nope. Okay. So, we need to let people know so that they are not be alone. So we can support each other in our families or friends. So people always, especially Asian people, always afraid of being judging. So don't worry about judging, being judging. So we can talk about that one to help difficulties, challenges in lives. So it's okay to express hopelessness, helplessness. It's okay. So we can tell other people these things, we can do it. So other people at experiencing mental health symptoms. So not only you, it's many people experience these difficulties, challenges. So just, you know, we can open-minded, we can discuss always. People want to help other people. So just share the difficulties, challenging. So I know in Asian people in general, it's difficult to seeking professional help, but you can discuss with your family first, then you can seek a little more professional help. So always we can encourage other people to talk, you know, you or friends or mental health professionals that you can do.
所以就是处理我们心理健康的情况，最重要就是让病人知道他们不是孤单的。就是第一，就是他们去讨论自己的情况的时候，就是不要害怕被其他人去批评，就是他们就会觉得其他人去怎么看他们，就是鼓励他们去跟身边其他的人去讨论自己的情绪，就是让他们知道这个情况是有希望的，就是可以 赚好的一些情况。然后另外呢，就是可以让他们知道，其实很多人都是会有心理上面的情况，就是不同的阶段，我们人生有很多不同的情况，也是会有一些情况是有心理上面有压力的，所以不是他个人的问题，而是很多人都是会有同一个时间都会有这些问题的。然后另外就是他们跟你们去分享的时候，当然就是 维持一个开放的态度，就是让他们多说一点他们自己的感受。如果真的觉得他们是有需要的话呢，就是可以、鼓励他们去寻找一些专业的帮助、或者是你们如果是家人或者是朋友的时候，也是多鼓励他们主动去、寻找一些服务。最后呢，当然就是在过程当中 是有很多自己还有是照顾是需要给这个病人的，就是、多多就是支持他们、去 找帮助就是最好
的。希望直接这个、这个机会跟大家讲话你们的烦恼、你们的心事、就由我们帮你们分担一下。同埋另一樣嘢就係同大家放心咧，就係你哋所提供所有資料咧都全部保密嘅，所以放心。
嗯，所以就是跟專業人士去溝通的時候，也可以留意，其實他們是不會把你們的治療去分享給其他人的，所以是一個保密的一個情況去做。
All right. Do you have any questions, comments about this portion of the slide?
有人有没有观众是有问题
？Okay, so I believe next slide is our last slide. So, these are agencies you can refer to your friends, family, or yourself. So, of course, you know, Asian Health Services, that's a hosted. Also, San Francisco has a.Rounds, Richmond area, multi-services. I'm from CHA, Community Health for Asian Americans. We are most likely take children's only, some adult, but mainly children services. Aki, it's a San Jose area, has another agency. Also Brian from Kaiser. So, Kaida, treat to you.Mental health things too. Also, if you see other people with a suicidal, you can refer to National Suicide Hotline. Also, Alameda County has mobile crisis unit. It's really emergency situation for the adult. It's called John George Pavilion in San Leandro. Also, we lock it's.Children and adolescents, psychiatric emergency services. Also, you can go to website NAMI, it's National Alliance on Mental Illness. So the place has a lot of the resources along with these agencies.
所以在湾区其实有很多不同的机构也是有提供心理辅导或者是精神健康的服务，比如说我们是亚健社，我们是有一个专门的专科，精神健康的专科。然后另外一些机构比如说是 RAMS， 还有就是、Community Health for Asian Americans， Asian American Community Involvement， 他们都是主要是服务亚洲人的。然后 KISA或者是 National Suicide Hotline， 或者是 Alameda County 的，这一些就是、就是、全部人都他们都会服务的。然后有一些就是、议员，就是譬如说 John George Pavilion， 就是主要是服务成人的一个、精神病的议员。然后另外 Willow Rock 就是一个服务小朋友跟青少年为主的一个议员。然后你们也可以去、那个 NAMI 的 National Alliance on Mental Illness 的一个网站，他们也是一个在湾区比较大的一个机构，就是有很多关于精神健康上面的、服务啊还有治疗，你们可以 去网上面去看。
其實荃灣區都有好多機構都可以幫到大家，尤其是東灣，東灣最出名的就是 Asian Health Services， 就在唐浮阿健社，然後南灣都有一個叫做 Asian American Community Involvement 同第二個大機構都係 Kaiser 嘅，所以喺每一個保險裏面，你自己醫療保險裏面就會。
有提供所有资料，同埋可以话俾你听去边一个机构嗰度嚟寻找服务嘅。所以就是你们也可以去留意自己的保险是覆盖是什么的服务，譬如说我们亚健是主要是服务东湾的居民，然后譬如说CHAA 他们AACI 他们就是主要是南湾的一些服务，譬如说 Kaiser 就是我们。 湾区很多地方都是有的一些服务，可以去了解一下你们的保险是覆盖了什么的服务。Okay,
so our presentation is about this. How can get out from? Just there. Thank you.
所以我们今天的presentation 就是大概是这样，以下的时间我们就是可以有一些 Q&A question and answer 的时间，如果观众是有什么问题的话，现在可以提出。
Other question, comments?
今次咧係同大家第一次見面，係有可能我都覺得有少少做得唔係咁足夠，所以同大家講一聲唔好意思先啦。咁下一次咧，就希望可以幫到再同大家見面，然後再更加再做好啲。如果有咩問題啊，有新聞嘢feedback啊，可以提供嘅話，可以即刻去揾阿健社提供啦。咁我哋會以你嘅 feedback 嚟講，會再去跟進嘅啦。
因为今天呢，我们是Brian 跟 Hero 他们第一次跟我们去分享，所以如果你们是有什么建议的话，可以提出。然后他们在四月份的时候，四月的时间还是会有另外一场的讲座，就是跟我们去讨论情绪健康管理的。然后我们每一个月，我们亚健社也是每一个月有不同的seminar 还有 workshop。 会跟大家去分享不同的情绪健康管理的一些治疗，还有一些技巧的。We're
gonna come back in April. So we're gonna talk about more family relation the next time. So any questions, comments?
大家有什么问题想问吗？咁好啦，咁啊，今次同大家讲多谢嚟参加呢一个讲座啦，咁再次。 恭祝大家啦！咁牛年行行运啦，身体健康，同埋能龙马精神。好，那谢谢大家的参与。我们今天呢会把我们今天的这个讲座
upload 到上载到我们的 YouTube 的 channel 的，所以就是如果是想跟你们的朋友，如果他们今天没有时间去参加的时候，你们可以到我们的 YouTube channel。 我们在这里一个 flyer 上面也是有我们 YouTube channel 的 link 的，所以可以再到那边去看看。好，那就谢谢大家的参与。